The Firemote project is happy to announce official support for Homatics media players. Included with the new release, there are also four additional remote styles that you can choose. These new remotes can be used when configuring any Firemote card. In this video, I will be using a Dune HD Homatics Box R 4K+, like the one that you see on your screen now. Let's take a brief look at the setup and operations of this new edition. The very first thing we need to do is to enable a feature called USB Debugging. First, navigate to the Settings menu and open it. Scroll down to select Device Preferences. From here, click on About. Finally, scroll down until you find Android TV OS Build. Click on this menu option 8 times, or until a message appears that says, "You are now a developer." Press the back button on your remote, then scroll down to find a new option in this menu called Developer Options. Find the switch labeled USB Debugging and turn it on. When asked if you want to allow this, simply select OK. If you don't already have the Firemote card, downloading it through HACS is the easiest way to get it. After opening HACS, type Firemote into the search bar. When it appears below, click on it. From here, it's as simple as clicking the download button and clicking on download once more. Now it's time to connect Home Assistant to our Homatics device using two integrations. It's possible that Home Assistant has already discovered your device, like you see here. Let's navigate to Settings, then Devices and Services. Once here, click the Add Integration button. The first integration we are going to use can be found by searching for Android Debug Bridge. To set up this integration, we will need the IP address from our Homatics box. Open the Settings menu, select Device Preferences, About, and Status. This screen shows us the IP address of our Homatics device. Simply type that address into the box and click Submit. Your Homatics device will show a screen like this, asking for permission to allow Home Assistant to connect with ADB. Click the checkbox and select Allow. Immediately after that, Home Assistant will show a success screen. You can assign this to an area, then click Finish. It's also a good idea to name any new device integration. This will come in handy later when you want to use it. Now on to the last integration. This one is called Android TV Remote. Since Home Assistant has already discovered it, I can simply click on Configure, then Submit. At this time, you will need to enter the pairing code that shows up on your device into the Home Assistant PIN code box. Click Submit, assign an area, then Finish. Now it's finally time to add a Homatics Firemote card to our dashboard. Open any dashboard, and as you always do, click on the Add Card button. You can type Firemote into the search bar. Once you see it appear, click on it. Configuration is very simple through the visual editor. Under Device Family, we will select Homatics. Under Homatics Device Model, I will select Dune HD. Now, we select the integrations we just added. The first one is the ADB integration, followed by the Android TV Remote integration. You can adjust the size of the remote here and make any other changes you'd like. Click Save, and it's ready to go. Every single button on your Firemote card is designed to work exactly like your physical remote control. We can easily navigate around the screen by clicking on the direction pad. We can also launch apps, like YouTube, using the buttons at the bottom. One great feature that Firemote has is a built-in keyboard. Let's use it to search for some videos on YouTube. Did you know that you don't have to keep the default remote style? You can select any kind of remote that you want. This is what each of the new Homatics options look like. I'm going to stick with Style 4 for now. Also, below this long list of pre-built application launcher buttons, there are some special functions. Let's try a few of them and see what they do. Clicking on the Apps button brings us here, where we can see all of our currently installed apps. Clicking the Recents button shows us all of the currently open apps. From here, we could choose to close them all if we want. The Update button can help us keep our system up to date. And of course, the Restart button. Home Assistant will first confirm with you that you want to restart, and once you say it's okay, your device will restart. Don't forget to take a look at the Firemote GitHub page to see all of the other amazing ways you can customize Firemote. Until next time, enjoy!